Good evening, YWAM family. How are you doing tonight?
Buenas noches, familia de Jocum. ¿Cómo estamos?
My name is Edwin Phyllis, and I'm from a YWAM campus in Cape Town, South Africa.
Su nombre es Edwin Phyllis, y es de un campus en África del Sur.
And this is my good friend Giacomo, all the way from Costa Rica.
Y mi nombre es Giacomo, y soy de Costa Rica.
And so we're really excited about tonight.
Estamos bien emocionados en esta noche.
The theme for tonight,
el tema para esta noche,
is ending Bible poverty together.
Es erradicando la pobreza bíblica hoy.
Do you believe that this is possible in our generation?
¿Crees tú que esto es posible en nuestra generación?
That our goal is zero.
Nuestra meta es cero.
Zero unreached people groups.
Cero grupos no alcanzados.
Zero individuals who've never heard the good news of Jesus Christ.
Cero personas, naciones que no han escuchado las buenas nuevas de Jesucristo.
And zero languages who don't have the scriptures in their language.
Y cero idiomas que no tienen la escritura en su propio idioma.
And so tonight I invite you to an exciting evening.
Así que en esta noche les invito a una noche emocionante.
And we believe that God is going to meet with us.
Y creemos que Dios se va a reunir con nosotros.
How many of you enjoyed last night? Wasn't that absolutely amazing?
¿Cuántos de ustedes disfrutaron anoche? ¿No fue excelente?
I think something really happened last night.
Algo de verdad sucedió anoche.
What a demonstration of unity.
¿Qué demostración de unidad?
Among different ministries, different giftings in the body of Christ.
Diferentes ministerios, diferentes dones en medio del cuerpo de Cristo.
And the thing, it is not just about tolerating diversity.
Y el asunto no es solo acerca de tolerar la diversidad.
But last night we saw a demonstration of what.
Pero anoche vimos una demostración
of what can happen when we embrace diversity.
De qué es lo que puede suceder cuando abrazamos la diversidad.
And this is just reminding me,
y eso me recuerda a mí,
of what history is moving towards.
What's that?
It reminds me what history is moving towards.
Es lo que me recuerda es hacia dónde nos está llevando la historia.
Revelation chapter 7:9, when John saw a great multitude.
Apocalipsis 7:9, cuando Juan vio una gran multitud.
That no one could count from every nation.
Que nadie podía contar de cada nación.
Every people.
Cada pueblo.
Every tribe and
cada
every language.
Y cada idioma.
Why don't you just stand up tonight
and just, a que tomemos de pie en esta noche,
and just think of one highlight of what God did since last night, this morning, and this afternoon.
Pensemos en un aspecto sobresaliente, algo que resaltó de anoche, hoy en la mañana y hoy en la tarde.
And turn to the person next to you or behind you and just share that highlight.
Y después comparte con la persona que está a la par de ti ese aspecto sobresaliente.
And then pray for one another.
Y después oremos los unos por los otros.
That God will indeed meet with us tonight.
Que Dios de verdad se reúna con nosotros en esta noche.
That God will give us revelation.
Que Dios nos dé esa revelación.
Find somebody, share.
Encuentra a alguien, comparte.
And pray for one another.
Y oren los unos por los otros.
Let's lift up our voices. Pray for more.
Señor, oramos por mucho más.
We're grateful for what you're doing in our midst, but we are trusting you for more.
Señor, pedimos por mucho más.
We are expecting for you to meet with us tonight.
Señor, estamos anticipando que te quieres reunir con nosotros.
Hallelujah.
En esta noche.
We raise our level of expectation tonight.
Señor, aumentamos el nivel de anticipación.
Take your eyes in this room tonight.
Thank you, Lord. On my left-hand side tonight, we have an expression of worship tonight. We've got Christian.
De este lado tenemos a Christian con una expresión de adoración.
From YWAM London.
De Hukum, London.
And a ministry called Radiant that he's leading.
Y un ministerio que se llama Radiant que él está dirigiendo.
We are really privileged tonight to have Lindy and the band leading us in worship tonight.
Y también tenemos un grupo de adoración dirigiéndonos en esta noche.
And we want to give tonight honor and glory to Jesus.
Y en esta noche queremos darle honra y gloria a Jesús.
Because Jesus is worthy tonight. How many of you believe it tonight?
Porque Jesús es digno de eso, lo creemos.
He's worthy to receive worship, honor, adoration.
Él es digno de recibir honra y gloria de adoración.
From every people, every
tongue, every
language.
De cada pueblo, de cada idioma, de cada lenguaje.
You know the amazing thing is.
Lo increíble de todo esto es.
When I was growing up, I had a vision.
Que cuando yo crecí, yo tenía una visión.
And my vision was just to go from my village to the next town.
Y mi visión era ir de una pequeña comunidad al próximo pueblo.
And that town was 15 miles away, 20 kilometers away.
Y de esa aldea a este pueblo había 20 kilómetros de distancia.
But that is how big my vision was.
Eso era qué tan grande era mi visión.
But when Jesus took hold of me,
pero cuando Jesús me agarró,
his dream became my dream.
Su sueño se hizo mi sueño.
And God took a little African boy from a little African village.
Y Dios tomó un pequeño niño africano de una aldea africana.
Everything in my life was small.
Todo en mi vida era pequeño.
The youngest of 10 kids.
El más joven de 10 niños.
A small house.
Una casa pequeña de tierra.
Small village.
Una aldea pequeña.
Small chickens, small dogs, small cockroaches.
Pequeñas cucarachas, pequeño de todo.
Everything was small.
Todo era pequeño.
But it's amazing when this big God takes
pero
hold of you.
Es lo increíble es que este Dios increíble me agarró.
He gives you
y él te da
his dream,
su sueño.
And his dream is an impossible dream.
Y es un sueño imposible.
And tonight I pray
y en esta noche yo oro
that God will release dreams in our hearts tonight.
Que Dios libere sueños en sus corazones.
Impossible dreams.
Sueños imposibles.
That we can be part of his dream.
Que nosotros podamos ser parte de su sueño.
To see the great commission completed in our generation.
De ver la gran comisión siendo alcanzada.
Let's worship the Lord tonight.
Adoremos al Señor en esta noche.
Who's ready to worship Jesus? Come on. We just love you, Jesus. Oh, we thank you for your love that's been encountering us, Jesus. We open up our hearts tonight, Jesus, to receive a fresh encounter of your love. See, in Christ alone. And in Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. Come on, in one heights of in Christ alone. who took on flesh, the fullness of God in heaven's bed. This gift of love and righteousness, he scorned by the ones he came to save, but to on that cross has Jesus died. But then bursting forth in glorious day, and up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, since curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine. I'm bought with the precious blood.
Raise this life for some good.
Jesus, we love you, Jesus. There's just something about his love. There's something about his love in this place tonight. We can go even deeper. He's taking us even deeper. And some of you have been asking, God, I want a fresh revelation of your love. Get ready, 'cause tonight I see wave after wave of his love, wave after wave of his love crashing in. So we sing our Father, and all of heaven roars your name. Sing louder, let this place hear with praise. Can you hear it? It's the sound of heaven touching earth. It's the sound of heaven touching earth. Our Father, all of heaven rows your name. Sing louder, let this place erupt with praise. Can you hear it? It's the sound of heaven touching earth. Come on, we can hear it. We can hear it. The sound of heaven touching earth.
Spirit, break out. Break all walls down. Come on. Spirit, break out.
To this song, we're going to move into a time of intercession for university campuses. We heard it said from, I believe it was Mike Bickle last night, praying for 200,000 staff members to come and join us, believing for a fresh student volunteer movement across America and across university campuses in the nations. Amen. So I'm going to invite Chase Kofer, who's a part of the Circuit Rider community in Orange County, the husband of Lindy Kofer. And Chase is one of the pioneers of that community that's leading out in university campuses. He's going to lead us in a few minutes of intercession. So take us there, Chase.
Amen. You guys doing good? Isn't the presence of the Lord so good tonight? Well, I just agree with what Aaron said, is that we're going to see another student volunteer missions movement, not just out of America, but I believe every nation on the earth with a university. We're going to see a missions movement like we've never seen before start this year. And so can we start by praying two things? In Matthew 9, Jesus said that the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. So the first thing, can we pray that there would be a great harvest on the universities of the world right now? And then the second thing we're going to pray is we're going to pray that there would be a labor force sent out from the universities that we've never seen before this year. So get in groups of three or four right where you're at, and let's begin to cry out that God would see a great harvest and we'd see labor sent out into the harvest field from the universities in the world. Amen? Amen. Let's do it. We're going to keep praying, but I just want to stir your faith a little bit more. Darlene just came up and told me that all across the world right now, the entirety of YWAM is praying for universities across the world. So all across the world, all of YWAM is taking today to intercede that there would be a student volunteer missions movement out of the universities of the world. So can we go one more minute in faith that we would see a student volunteer missions movement like never before? Can we go one more minute with all of our hearts, and there will be movement with the rest of YWAM around the world. Amen? Let's keep going.
You've said, Jesus.
Amen. So tonight, Jesus, with hearts full of faith, God, we just ask you, Jesus, that even tonight, that university students all across the world, Jesus, tonight, we ask that they would give you a wholehearted yes to surrender their life to make you famous, Jesus. That in every university across the world, God, there would be wholehearted yeses to make Jesus famous. And we just say, Jesus, that the harvest is ripe. We believe you, God. And we just say, send laborers, God, from universities around the world. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Well, in the spirit of that, we're going to do a new song tonight. It's called Take Courage. Raise your hand if you know this song. It was written in YWAM Kona in a response to one night of praying for laborers, praying that God would send out laborers into the harvest, and that wholehearted yes. And so we're going to sing these verses, and we get to the chorus just to stay in that intercession of what is possible with God. Anything, anything, anything. And we just lay down. We do our little part. We lay down our lives to do whatever you would ask God. And so the chorus, we're going to sing, take courage. The harvest is ripe. Lift up your voice because Jesus is alive. Amen. Jesus, we believe the harvest is ready. Sing, we're shaking off the dust. We're shaking off the dust as we arise. Awake, awake, our generation cries. Salvation song will ring throughout the earth. Oh, we know that every eye will see your matchless worth.
Courage.
This is the greatest love encounter. The greatest love encounter. To know what you did made anything possible for Jesus. Sing, there's a yes. There's a yes.
He's alive.
Sabemos que Jesús está vivo.
Guys, can we give one more shout to Jesus because he is alive.
Una celebración más a Jesús porque él está vivo.
We shout out to you, Lord. You're alive. We say yes.
Él dice sí.
We say yes.
Say sí.
We will go.
Vamos a ir.
Oh. We can just go on worshiping Jesus.
Continuaríamos adorando al Señor Jesús.
Aren't you longing for this day before His throne? We will just keep worshiping and worshiping.
Y seguiríamos adorándole y adorándole.
Lindy and the band, thank you so much
for
serving
us. Gracias.
Great working with you. Let's give a hand.
Démosles un aplauso.
To these wonderful people that are serving us.
Esta gente maravillosa quienes nos están sirviendo.
Family, do you love this incredible celebrations we have in the evenings?
¿Cuántos han amado estas preciosas celebraciones que hemos tenido en estas noches?
With just such absolute diversity, I mean, looking at Christian, what he's doing.
Con la gran diversidad que tenemos, viendo aquí a Christian, lo que está haciendo.
But also the different teams that have been performing.
Pero también los diferentes equipos que han estado actuando.
It's more than a performance, it's really a demonstration.
Es más que una actuación, sino es una demostración.
Of the heart of God.
Del corazón de Dios.
And so we've been so blessed by different expressions.
Así que hemos sido bendecidos por la gran variedad de expresiones.
This group that I'm introducing you tonight.
Este grupo que les voy a presentar en esta noche.
The first time I saw them was in July of this year.
La primera vez que los vi fue este julio de este año.
And it was in Switzerland.
Y fue en Suiza.
And I was just blown away when I saw them performing during the Montreux Jazz Festival.
Me sorprendí la vez que los vi actuar en ese festival de jazz.
And this evening I want to introduce to you Tret,
y esta
their dance
noche
company.
Les quiero presentar esta compañía de danza Tret.
And later on we're going to have Heartbridge, who has blessed us this whole week.
Y después vamos a tener Heartbridge, que nos ha bendecido toda la semana.
And tonight we're going to have some surprises for you.
Y tenemos algunas sorpresas también esta noche para ustedes.
But Tret, they love to have the crowd participate with them.
Pero vamos a tener esta anticipación de Tret.
And so as they are getting ready.
Y a medida que se están preparando.
So I'm not going to come back up. So I would like you to welcome tonight.
Me gustaría que le dieran la bienvenida en esta noche.
Tret and then Heartbridge after them.
A Tret y después a Heartbridge.
Let's just show our appreciation.
Demostrémosle nuestro aprecio.
For these wonderful people tonight.
Para esta gente maravillosa en esta noche.
Please put your hands together for them again.
Les damos un aplauso, por favor.
Wasn't that magnificent?
¿No fue eso magnificente?
The grace of the fan dance.
La gracia de esa danza de los abanicos.
The power of the drums.
El poder de los tambores.
The intimacy in the worship.
La intimidad de la adoración.
What an amazing God we have.
Qué Dios tan sorprendente que tenemos.
What a delightful tribe we belong to.
Qué tribu más especial a la cual pertenecemos.
Tonight I have the joy of introducing to you
en esta noche,
a very dear friend.
Tengo el placer de presentarles a un amigo muy querido.
Roy Peterson.
Roy Peterson.
I have known him for 17 years.
Lo he conocido por 17 años.
And for the last 30 years, he has been a very crucial person
y por
in
los
the Bible movement.
30 años ha sido una persona muy crucial en el movimiento bíblico.
For 10 years, he served in Ecuador and Guatemala.
Por 10 años ha servido en Ecuador y en Guatemala.
Then 6 years, he served as president of Wycliffe USA.
6 años sirvió como presidente de Wycliffe, Estados Unidos.
Then he gave 11 years serving as the leader of the Seed Company, the fastest growing Bible translation entity.
Y después 11 años sirvió en la compañía Seed, que es la compañía más creciente en la traducción bíblica.
And in the last 3 years, he has been the president and CEO of the American Bible Society.
Y en los últimos años ha sido el presidente ejecutivo de la Sociedad Bíblica Americana.
All those titles may not mean very much to you.
Todos esos títulos tal vez no les significan mucho a ustedes.
But let me tell you a couple things that will.
Pero déjeme contarle un par de cosas bien.
In the last 20 years of his leadership,
en los últimos 20 años de su liderazgo,
together with the teams that serve with him,
junto con los equipos con quienes colaboró,
directly under his leadership,
directamente bajo su liderazgo,
1,200 languages have begun to be translated into the scriptures.
Idiomas han comenzado su traducción bíblica.
More than one out of six languages on earth have been translated because of this man's leadership.
Uno de los seis idiomas mundiales han sido traducidos por el liderazgo de este hombre.
Half of the languages that have been published or are in process the last 20 years have been under this man's leadership in the whole world. Half of the languages.
La mitad de los idiomas.
Of all the languages translated in the world.
De todos los idiomas traducidos en el mundo.
In the last 20 years.
En los últimos 20 años.
Have been under this man's passionate visionary leadership.
Han estado bajo el liderazgo apasionado de este hombre.
Jesus says, "By your fruit you shall know them."
Jesús dice que por sus frutos les conoceréis.
And he's been his passion to make God's dream come true.
Y él ha tenido esta pasión de ver hacer el sueño de Dios realidad.
And make sure that everyone had a chance to hear.
Y asegurarse que todos tengan la oportunidad de escuchar.
Has borne amazing fruit.
Ha sido un fruto increíble.
But let me say something else.
Déjeme decir algo más.
His character reflects that of Jesus.
Su carácter refleja este de Jesús.
He's been in my home.
Él ha estado en mi hogar.
I've had the privilege of being in his.
Él ha tenido el privilegio de estar en su hogar.
We've shared times together.
Hemos compartido tiempos juntos.
He's taught and I've learned.
Él ha enseñado y yo he aprendido.
He's wept and I've been moved.
Él ha gemido y yo he sido conmovido.
He's simple.
Él es simple,
humble,
humilde.
He's transparent.
Transparente.
You're going to love this man.
Ustedes van a amar a este hombre.
I love this man.
Yo amo a este hombre.
Would you welcome my friend,
le daría
Roy
la bienvenida
Peterson.
A mi amigo Roy Peterson.
Hi.
Hola.
The desire to see the word go out comes out of brokenness.
El deseo de ver la palabra salir surge de un quebrantamiento.
As a 19-year-old,
como un chico de 19 años,
I had ruined my life and approached the Lord Jesus out of brokenness.
Me acerqué al Señor Jesús por razón de quebrantamiento.
I had experienced Bible poverty firsthand.
Había experimentado la pobreza bíblica de primera mano.
I experienced the truth that the wages of sin is death.
Experimentar las verdades que las pagas del pecado traen muerte.
And I share your passion.
Y comparto su pasión.
That no one else on the earth should ever have to live that way.
Que nadie en el mundo debería de vivir de esta forma.
Every man, woman, and child on the planet should have an opportunity.
Hombre, mujer y niño en el planeta debiese de tener esta oportunidad.
Being here tonight with you is a 30-year dream. Being here tonight with you
aquí con ustedes en esta noche
is a dream of 30 years.
Es un sueño de 30 años.
You see, we're going to see the end of Bible poverty.
Vamos a ver el final de la pobreza bíblica.
And we're going to do it together.
Y lo vamos a hacer juntos.
This gives the Lord so much joy that the body of Christ is working together.
Él se le trae tal gozo al Señor Jesús que el cuerpo de Cristo trabaje unidamente.
And that's what brings us together tonight.
Y eso es lo que nos une en esta noche.
We share so many values together.
Compartimos tantos valores juntos.
I've spent so much time with Lauren, Darlene,
he tomado
and David,
tanto tiempo con Lauren, con David, con Darlene,
Mark and Karen,
and
your leadership.
Su liderazgo.
And you know, American Bible Society is now 200 years old.
Americana tiene 200 años.
Our founder was born in 1740
Nuestro
in Philadelphia.
Fundador nació en 1740 en Filadelfia.
And it occurred to me while I was here
y se me ocurrió mientras que estaba aquí,
that if Lauren had been born in 1740, he would have been the president of American Bible Society.
Que si Lauren hubiera nacido en 1740, él hubiera sido el presidente de la Sociedad Bíblica Americana.
He loves the Word of God so much.
Él ama la palabra de Dios de tal manera.
He wants the whole world to have it.
Que él quiere que todo el mundo la tenga.
He doesn't want another day to go by.
Él no quiere que ningún otro día pase.
The scriptures aren't in the hands of every person.
Si la escritura no está en las manos de cada persona.
And so that brings us together.
Así que eso nos reúne en esta noche.
You see, Bible poverty
ustedes ven que la pobreza bíblica
has many forms.
Tiene muchas formas.
We immediately think of giving somebody the scripture.
Inmediatamente pensamos en darle a alguien la escritura.
But now we know today
pero hoy día ya sabemos
people have the scriptures,
que las personas tienen la escritura,
but are they using them?
Pero la pregunta es, ¿las están utilizando?
Are they building their relationship with Christ?
¿Están edificando esa relación con Jesucristo?
Is their life alive in faith with their Savior?
Hay una relación vida, viva con su Salvador.
And so you can be surrounded by people and still be lonely.
Que tú puedes aún estar rodeado por personas y estar solitario o solitaria.
You can have food all around you and still be hungry.
Puedes tener comida todo a tu alrededor y aún tener hambre.
And you can have Bibles all around you and still be starving for the Word.
Biblias a todo a tu alrededor y estar con un hambre de la palabra.
And so getting the Bibles to everyone, we still have to do that.
Así que todavía tenemos que llevar la Biblia a todas las personas.
But now we have to help the world engage with the
Pero
scriptures.
Ahora tenemos que ayudar al mundo a que se involucre con la escritura.
And one of the things that's holding people back
y una de las cosas que está evitando, reteniendo a las personas
is the war and terror and woundedness of our world.
En la lucha, el terror, el quebrantamiento de nuestro mundo.
The enemy is hurting so many hearts.
El enemigo está doliendo a tantos corazones
in all countries.
En todos los países.
Both genders.
Ambos sexos.
It doesn't matter the age.
No importa la edad.
People are being wounded all over our world.
La gente está siendo lastimada alrededor de todo nuestro mundo.
And the enemy thinks that's going to keep them from knowing God.
Y el enemigo piensa que eso va a evitar que ellos lleguen a conocer de Dios.
But the word itself will bring healing.
Pero la palabra como tal va a traer sanidad.
And so tonight we're going to celebrate what Así, God is doing.
Que en esta noche vamos a celebrar lo que Dios está haciendo.
There'll be at least one thing I'm going to say to you, and I know you're all going to be up on your feet cheering.
Hay una cosa que yo les voy a decir y ustedes se van a parar en ovación.
So even though we have that word poverty up there,
y ahora aunque tengamos esta palabra aquí que dice pobreza,
and there is a remaining need,
y sí falta una necesidad,
there are things happening that we're going to celebrate tonight.
Hay cosas que están sucediendo que vamos a celebrar en esta noche.
This is an incredible time in history.
Este es un tiempo increíble en la historia.
And you are part of that history.
Y tú eres parte de esta historia.
God is weaving you into it tonight.
Dios está entretejiendo en esto en esta noche.
And it'll be part of your legacy through the rest of your life.
De tu legado para el resto de tu vida.
Your life will count for making sure the word
tu vida
is everywhere.
Va a cantar para va a contar en llevar la palabra a todo lugar.
Let's talk about translation.
Hablemos acerca de traducción.
100% of the languages of the world need the scripture.
100% de los idiomas del mundo necesitan la escritura.
YWAM has been helping with translation.
Hukum ha estado ayudando con la traducción.
We've been working in a partnership in the Pacific.
Hemos estado trabajando en un compañerismo, en una alianza en el Pacífico.
YWAM has helped to accelerate Bible translation.
Y Hukum ha ayudado a acelerar la traducción bíblica.
It's only the beginning, though, of what you can do.
Solo es el inicio de lo que ustedes pudiesen hacer.
Every single people group has to have the Word of God in their language.
Cada pueblo necesita tener la palabra de Dios en su idioma.
We recently came upon a church in Zambia.
Recientemente llegamos a una iglesia en Zambia.
This is a church in Zambia.
Esta es una iglesia en Zambia.
The people group is called Nsenga.
El grupo tribal se llama Nsenga.
Nsenga. They thought
ellos pensaron
using the scriptures from another language
que utilizar las escrituras de otro idioma.
They never had the Bible in Nsenga.
Que nunca habían tenido la Biblia en enseña.
They thought that the story of Lazarus,
ellos pensaron que la historia de Lázaro,
was a story on how to appropriately bury somebody.
Era la historia apropiada de cómo enterrar a alguien.
And as we worked with them,
y a medida que nosotros trabajamos junto con ellos,
to translate the Bible into Nsenga,
para traducir la Biblia en enseña,
the church exploded in joy.
La iglesia explotó en gozo.
Lazarus came back to life.
Lázaro resucitó.
They had never known that before.
Ellos nunca habían aprendido esto.
They thought it was about burying the dead.
Ellos pensaron que era cerca de enterrar a los muertos.
And so you can see this was a church.
Así que después puedes ver es una iglesia.
And yet they had Bible poverty.
Y aún así tenían pobreza bíblica.
They didn't have it in their heart language.
No lo tenían en su idioma natal.
And the power of the stories of the Bible.
En el poder de las historias de la Biblia.
Were not impacting their lives.
No estaban impactando sus vidas.
Listen to this.
Escuchen esto.
You're alive at a moment in history.
Estás vivo y viva en un momento de la historia.
What I'm about to tell you.
Pero te voy a pronto decir.
93% of the people on the planet.
Que 93% de las personas en la faz de la tierra.
Have access to the Bible in their heart language.
Tienen acceso a la Biblia en su idioma natal.
Look at God. He is so passionate.
Él está tan apasionado.
He wants his word in every language.
Él quiere su palabra en cada idioma.
This poverty that we're talking about.
Esta pobreza de la cual estamos hablando.
Is down to 7% of the world.
Le llega al 7%
del mundo. We're going to see the completion of it.
Y podemos ver el cumplimiento del
tal. In our lifetime.
En nuestra vida.
And you're part of that story.
Y tú eres parte de esa historia.
Your prayers.
Tus oraciones.
Your passion, your going.
Tu pasión, tu ir.
Your giving.
Tu dar.
Going to bring the scriptures
puede llevar las escrituras
to the most hidden places on the planet.
A los confines más escondidos del planeta.
And look at how the Lord is doing it.
Y miren cómo el Señor lo está haciendo.
Here's a little picture of the hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of agencies.
Un vistazo de los cientos de cientos de agencias.
And look who I put in the middle of the picture.
Y miren a quién puse en el centro de este diagrama.
That's how I feel about you.
Así me siento acerca de ustedes.
You can be part of this.
Ustedes pueden ser parte de esto.
So every single people group has God's word.
Con cada pueblo étnico.
This kind of partnership has never happened before.
Tiempo de alianza nunca antes ha sucedido.
Everybody was doing good things.
Todo el mundo estaba haciendo cosas buenas.
They all had their little place of the story.
Todos tenían su lugar en la historia.
And they were behaving themselves.
Y sí, se estaban comportando entre sí.
They were being good Bible translators.
Estaban siendo buenos traductores bíblicos.
But today they're joining hands.
Pero hoy están entrelazando manos.
Yeah. And organizations that used to think
organizaciones que solían pensar
that they were not part of the story.
Que no eran parte de la historia.
Oh, this is for the Bible societies.
Oh, no, esto es para la sociedad bíblica.
Or this is for Wycliffe.
O esto es para Wycliffe.
But organizations like yours are saying, no, we can be a part.
Pero organizaciones como la de ustedes están diciendo, podemos ser parte de esto.
Yesterday I was at a meeting of the elders.
Ayer estaba en una reunión con
the leaders of YWAM.
Con los líderes de Hukum.
I didn't like it when they called me an elder.
No me gusta cuando me llaman un anciano.
But they included me.
Pero ellos me incluyeron.
And they said to the group, they said, anyone that's here today is a YWAMer.
Dijeron, todo el que está aquí hoy es un jucumero.
So I'm looking around.
Así
I'm
que
a,
yo miro
I'm
alrededor,
a YWAMer.
Y yo digo, yo soy jucumero.
It's official.
Es oficial.
And so what's happening,
entonces, lo que está sucediendo,
and what I want to say to you tonight,
y lo que le quiero compartir en esta noche,
is that you are now Bible translators.
Es que ahora ustedes son traductores bíblicos.
You are now part of the Bible translation movement.
Ustedes son parte del movimiento de traducción bíblica.
I just said so.
Nada más yo lo acabo de decir ya.
Lauren said so.
Lauren lo dijo también.
David says so.
David lo dijo.
YWAMers are part of the Bible translation movement.
Jucum es parte del movimiento de traducción bíblica.
That's the day we're in.
Ese es el día en el cual estamos hoy.
But translation doesn't look like it did a decade ago.
Pero la traducción no se ve como solía ser una década atrás.
You might have in your mind, if you're old enough, you
ustedes
might remember.
Pueden tener en su mente, si son personas de avanzada edad ya,
when Bible translation was sending somebody from the West.
Cuando los traductores bíblicos enviaban a alguien del oeste.
And that person from the West would do the translation.
Y esa persona del oeste hacía la traducción.
They would learn the language.
Aprendían el idioma.
They would live there for 10 or 20 years.
Vivían ahí por 10 o 20 años.
And they would work with the mother tongue speakers.
Y trabajaban con los nativos de habla de la localidad.
And they would create the scriptures in that language.
Y ellos trabajaban esas escrituras en ese idioma.
But for the last 1,000 languages,
pero para los últimos 1,000 idiomas,
you're going to see a story tonight that represents reality.
Van a ver una historia hoy noche que representa esa realidad.
The mother tongue speakers themselves are doing the translation.
Los nativos locales están haciendo la traducción.
And this is not 10 languages or 20 languages.
Y eso no son 10 o 20 idiomas.
This is not 100 languages
no son
or 200.
100 idiomas o 200.
More than the last 1,000 languages are like this story you're
más
about
de los
to
últimos
see.
Mil idiomas
it's
son
an
como
amazing
esa historia
development.
Que van a ver, y eso es un desarrollo increíble.
This brother, Reverend Doke.
Este hermano, Reverendo Doke.
He lives in northern India.
Él vive en el norte de la India.
He's a reverend.
Él es un reverendo.
And he didn't have the scriptures in his language.
Y él no tenía las escrituras en su idioma.
Please think about that.
Por favor,
think about it.
Piensa al respecto, piensa.
Think about being a believer.
Piensa en ser un creyente.
And you'd have to know a second language to read the Bible.
Y tú tienes que aprender un segundo idioma para leer la Biblia.
And he loves the Lord.
Y él ama al Señor.
He loves his people.
Él ama a su pueblo.
7,000 verses in just the New Testament.
7,000 versículos en el Nuevo Testamento.
And he began to translate them by himself.
Y él comenzó a traducirlos por sí mismo.
And we began to help him.
Y comenzamos a ayudarle.
And in record time, the New Testament was done.
Y en un tiempo récord se completó el Nuevo Testamento.
Let's look at his story, and I'll be right back up.
Veamos su historia y regreso a platicar.
Gallo means our climb down. Our forefathers climbed down from China to Tibet to this Arunachal. My name is Reverend Gode Doke, and my village is Genshi, Wexiang, Arunachal Pradesh. While I was a child, my parents died. Only my elder brother and elder sister, they brought up me. And then my maternal uncle, he was Christian. So when I was worried and all kinds of what to do, what not to do, that time he called me and tell me about Jesus Christ. Jesus will give you peace. And there, 1974, 17 April, I accepted Jesus as my personal savior. Again, I did not know anything about Christ, and I read Bible, Assamese, but I could not understand. So my maternal uncle took me to Nagaland. And after that, 2002, I was called by the society to translate New Testament into Gallo language. And Gallo New Testament was published in 2007. We don't have any written document, written language, that we have just a dialect. So when we translate this New Testament, our people, especially Christians, there's so much interest. And they said we are very happy. Before we learn from others, they're reading from Assamese and from Hindi, and sometimes interpreting to our dialect. But now we are reading ourselves, so we are happy. They feel that after reading, some references are from the Old Testament, like from Isaiah. Again, they want to know detail of the whole Bible. In New Testament, we learn that God sent His Son, Jesus Christ. But without creating how God sent, then they want to know how God wonderfully put this world. I'm speaking out Assamese also, Prithivi. So they're thinking that, so we want to know more about the whole Bible. That's why they decided for Old Testament translation. My commitment, as Paul said in Philippians chapter 1, 21 verse, for me to live is Christ, to die is gain.
So they're reading the New Testament.
Ahora están leyendo el Nuevo Testamento.
And they see that Paul mentions this man named Abraham.
Que Pablo habla de este hombre, Abraham.
Or Jesus mentions Jonah.
O Jesús menciona Jonás.
And they're asking, who's that?
Y ellos preguntan, ¿y quién es ese?
Who's Jonah?
¿Quién es Jonás?
Who's Abraham?
¿Quién es Abraham?
And so Reverend Doke says, I have to translate the Old Testament.
Reverendo Doke dice, tengo que traducir el Antiguo Testamento.
So he's doing the whole thing.
Así que está haciéndolo todo ahora.
To live is Christ.
Para vivir es Cristo.
To die is gain.
Morir es ganancia.
This is what's happening in our world
Esto
today.
Es lo que está sucediendo en nuestro mundo hoy
and
día.
You're going to come across opportunities like this all over the planet.
Y ustedes se van a encontrar oportunidades como estas
and
alrededor de todo el planeta.
And we want to work with you to launch these translation projects.
Y nosotros queremos trabajar junto con ustedes para lanzar esas traducciones bíblicas.
There's 1,600 languages that haven't started yet.
1,600 idiomas que no se han iniciado.
And you can help us start them.
Y ustedes nos pueden ayudar a iniciarlos.
Because you're now part of the Bible societies.
Porque ahora ustedes son parte de las sociedades bíblicas.
And I'm a YWAMer.
Y yo soy un jucumero.
So here's what the path looks like. We are
nosotros somos
trusting God.
Estamos confiando en Dios.
That by the year 2025,
que para el año 2025,
every language in the world,
cada idioma en el mundo,
will have some portion of Scripture,
tenga alguna porción de la Escritura,
enough to know Jesus,
suficiente para conocer a Jesús,
in their heart language,
en su idioma natal.
Can you say amen?
¿Pueden decir amén?
Amen, amen. I want to make sure I'm clear, though. Translation will not be done.
Quiero asegurarme de decir que la traducción no se va a completar.
They'll have enough to know Jesus.
Van a tener lo suficiente para conocer acerca de Jesús.
But we need more to disciple them.
Pero necesitamos más para discipularles.
And we're trusting that 8 years later.
Y estamos confiando que 8 años después.
By 2033.
En el 2033.
All the translation in the world that's needed.
Toda la traducción bíblica mundial que es necesaria.
Will be done, and we're going to have a party like unbelievable.
Y tengamos una fiesta como nunca antes la hemos tenido
God.
Con Dios.
If you'd like to know more,
si te gustase conocer más,
all of this partnership is happening under this banner.
Toda esta alianza está sucediendo bajo esta alianza.
Every tribe, every nation.org.
Cada tribu, cada nación.org en inglés.
Come there, log in.
Vengan, visiten el portal.
Learn about translation.
Aprendan acerca de la traducción.
Begin to pray.
Comiencen a orar.
Cultivate your heart.
Cultiven su corazón.
And be part of this amazing, amazing. Transformation.
Y sean parte de esta increíble transformación.
The second piece of poverty, Bible poverty,
el segundo tipo de pobreza bíblica que
is
que
here
hay.
In our own cities.
Está aquí en nuestras propias ciudades.
I know some of you
yo sé
are
que algunos
not
de ustedes
from the United States.
No son de Estados Unidos.
If you're not from the United States, would you please raise your
si
hand?
Si no eres de Estados Unidos, por favor, puede levantar tu mano.
I know you're not from here, but I know you love the United States anyway.
Yo sé que ustedes no son de aquí, pero de todas formas aman a Estados Unidos.
I know you love the church in this country.
Yo sé que ustedes aman a la iglesia de este país.
I know you pray for this country.
Yo sé que ustedes oran por este país.
And so all of us are invited.
Así que todos nosotros estamos invitados.
No matter where you live in the world.
No importando donde tú vivas en el mundo.
To be part and think about this dream.
Para ser parte y pensar en este sueño.
Of 100 million people in America.
100 millones de personas en Estados Unidos
actively engaged
activamente involucradas
in the word of God
en la palabra de Dios
in a life-changing way
en una forma que cambie sus vidas
every day
cada día.
How many are there right now, Roy?
¿Cuántos de estos hay hoy día?
Our research says there's about 46 million people.
Nuestra investigación dice que son aproximadamente 46 millones de personas
in this country
en este país
who are regularly involved
quien están regularmente involucrados
in the word of God.
En la palabra de Dios.
We're praying for a doubling.
Estamos orando para que esto se duplique
from 46 million
de 46 millones
to 100 million
a 100 millones
people in this country
personas en este país
in a life-changing way
de una forma que cambie su vida
engaged in the word of God
se involucre en la palabra de Dios.
Let me show you some statistics.
Déjenme compartir algunas estadísticas.
That little person in red
esa persona en rojo
represents 55 million people.
Representa 55 millones de personas.
One out of every five people
uno de cada cinco personas
does not believe in the Bible.
No cree en la Biblia.
They think it's a myth.
Piensan que es un mito.
They might even think it's destructive.
Tal vez pueden pensar aún que es destructiva.
They don't believe it's from God.
No creen que es de Dios.
And they're not even sure they want it in our country.
Ni siquiera saben si lo quieren en su país.
One fifth of our country in America feels that way.
Una quinta parte de las personas de Estados Unidos se piensan de esta forma.
If you're sitting next to somebody on a bus,
si tú estás sentado a la par de alguna persona en algún autobús,
there's a 20% chance.
Hay un 20% de posibilidades.
That's their worldview.
Que esa es su cosmovisión.
And if they're younger,
y si son más jóvenes,
the percentage goes higher.
El porcentaje incrementa.
And if they're my age,
y si son de la edad de él,
the percentage goes lower.
Disminuye.
Let me tell you what's happened.
Déjeme decirles qué es lo que está sucediendo.
It's 20% of our country.
20% de nuestro país.
Just 6 years ago.
6 años atrás.
Was only 10%.
Era solo 10%.
In 6 years of research.
En 6 años de investigación.
We've been measuring it has doubled the
hemos
cynicism.
Medido que ha duplicado el cinicismo.
The skepticism.
El escepticismo.
The antagonism towards the Bible.
El antagonismo contra la Biblia.
Has doubled.
Se ha duplicado.
Let me tell you the good news.
Déjeme decirle las buenas nuevas.
See the four blue people?
¿Ven las cuatro personas en azul?
That's the other 80%.
Ese son el otro 80%.
You're sitting on a bus.
Estás sentado en un bus.
8 chances out of 10.
8 de 10 posibilidades.
You're sitting next to somebody.
Estás sentado a la par de alguien.
That's engaged in the Bible.
Que está involucrado en la Biblia.
Or they're at least friendly towards the Bible.
O al menos son amistosos para con la Biblia.
Or they're just completely neutral. They don't know what to think about.
O tal vez completamente son neutrales y no saben qué pensar.
8 chances out of 10.
8 posibilidades de 10.
You can open up Source View.
Que tú puedes abrir el Source View.
And you can engage them in the Scriptures.
Y los puedes involucrar en la Escritura.
And they're going to be interested.
Y ellos van a estar interesados.
Let's start doing it.
Comencemos a hacer eso.
So we have an opportunity in this nation.
Tenemos una oportunidad en esta nación.
It's interesting that it's 100 million people.
Es algo interesante que son 100 millones de personas.
Are probably in our churches.
Que probablemente están en nuestras iglesias.
And yet they're not in the word.
Y aún así no están en la palabra.
And so we need to create a movement.
Así que nosotros tenemos que crear un movimiento.
Of love for God in his word.
De amor por Dios y su palabra.
And so the gift that you've been given
así,
this week.
Que el regalo que se les ha dado esta semana.
This new scripture tool that's right in the palm of our hands.
Esta nueva herramienta bíblica que está en la palma de su mano.
Which is so relationship based.
Que es tan fundamentada en la relación.
I believe God can use it.
Yo creo que Dios la puede utilizar.
To build a new generation of scripture engaged.
Para edificar una nueva generación de involucramiento bíblico.
And you can be part of that story.
Y tú puedes ser parte de esa historia.
100 million people
100 millones de personas
by the year 2025
para el año 2025
and the church is a sleeping giant
y la iglesia es un gigante durmiente.
If you'd like some more information,
si te gustase más información,
there's resources available to you in addition to what you got this week.
Hay recursos adicionales de los que ustedes ya recibieron esta semana.
We've got scripture engagement resources.
Tenemos recursos de involucramiento bíblico.
Free of charge.
Sin costo alguno.
They are yours.
Son suyos.
For you to use with your circles of influence.
Para que ustedes utilicen con sus círculos de influencia.
To see 100 million people
para
in America.
Como 100 personas en Estados Unidos.
Or you can go back to your own country.
O tú puedes regresar a tu propio país
and mobilize scripture engagement where you live.
Y movilizar el involucramiento bíblico donde tú vives.
In my 30 years of ministry, 30 years,
en mis 30 años de ministerio,
it has amazed me.
Me ha sorprendido.
That ministry within the church,
que el ministerio dentro de la iglesia,
would so often,
muy a menudo,
not include the scriptures.
No incluye las escrituras.
And we need to change that.
Y nosotros tenemos que cambiar eso.
Everything we do,
todo lo que hacemos,
one of our first thoughts is,
una de nuestros primeros pensamientos,
how do we build
es,
the word of God into this strategy?
¿Cómo edificar, incluir la palabra de Dios
make
en la estrategia,
it central to what
central
we're doing.
A lo que estamos haciendo.
Lastly,
como último punto,
we're going to talk about the wounded.
Vamos a hablar de aquellos que han sido lastimados o heridos
in our cities,
en nuestras ciudades
and around the world.
Y alrededor del mundo.
This issue of trauma,
este aspecto del trauma,
this issue of the wounded heart,
este aspecto del corazón dolido,
the headlines of today,
los encabezados de hoy día,
the people that we're seeing being driven out of their country,
las personas que estamos viendo siendo expulsadas
de sus
países,
losing their homes,
que están perdiendo sus hogares,
they're losing their loved ones,
están perdiendo a sus seres queridos,
their daughters are being kidnapped,
sus hijas están siendo
their sons are being
secuestradas, sus hijos
secuestrada,
secuestrada,
yeah, secuestrada,
secuestrada.
Actually, yes.
Sí.
He's good.
Es bueno.
I want to give you a glimpse. I know you're aware of this.
Yo quiero darle un vistazo. Yo sé que están apercibidos de esto.
Let's take one, just a clip from Kurdistan.
Tomemos este pequeño video de Kurdistán.
When ISIS comes, they will destroy a family. The children often lose their mother, they'll take her, rape her. They'll take hundreds of children, girls who are just 8 years old, 10 years old. They are taken and raped. I just can't believe people would do this. They will force little boys to train and fight like them, and if they refuse, they kill them. One of the big problems that we face is trauma with the families. They have left everything they've had behind. The parents, the families, they don't have jobs. They've had to fit their whole lives into small living spaces, sometimes 2 to 3 families at a time in one space. It's very difficult to plan a future with them. Will they have to flee again? Will we all have to flee at some point? They blame God for the terror they've had to endure. They lose their trust in him.
We discovered that a lot of people, they are traumatized. They need somebody to help. As Bible Society, I believe that the only solution for those is Jesus Christ.
When I first met some of the Yazidi women I work with, they couldn't even talk about the unspeakable things that happened to them. It takes time getting to know them, to talk to them. They can see in our eyes that we love them differently than others. This is why the trauma healing training through the American Bible Society has been so important. The literature and training we've received from the Bible Society has enabled us to help and heal people who are going through these traumatic experiences.
يعني قد ما كان يعني إيماننا قوي الله طلعنا دفعة واحدة وما ينسى إحنا أولاده.
This I want to tell you, this is the truth that we are, as the Bible cited, healing the trauma through the Bible, through the literatures we have it to heal those people in need and change their life from the darkness to the light.
The church has not been prepared.
La iglesia no ha sido preparada
for the level of trauma that's happening in our world today.
Para el nivel de trauma que nuestro mundo está experimentando hoy día.
This methodology has combined scripture.
Esta metodología ha incluido escritura.
Over 150 passages of scripture.
Más de 150 pasajes bíblicos.
Combined with the best practices of mental health.
Combinado con las mejores prácticas de salud mental.
Bringing people into small healing groups.
Trayendo a personas a grupos pequeños de sanidad.
Getting them to share the violence that they've experienced.
Que ellos compartan la violencia que han experimentado.
Going on a journey of forgiving the perpetrator.
Y de esta forma entrando en una jornada de perdón con aquel perpetrador.
Forgiving God because they've been so angry with God.
Perdonando a Dios porque están tan enojados con Dios.
Reconciling with Him.
Reconciliándoles con Él.
And then taking the horrible pain to the cross of Christ.
Ese dolor horrible a la cruz de Cristo.
We have seen the hardest cases in the world.
Hemos visto los casos más difíciles en el mundo.
Being led through these scriptures.
Siendo dirigidos a través de la escritura.
In a small group.
En grupos pequeños,
and people are being healed.
Y la gente ha experimentado sanidad.
By the thousands.
Por los miles.
It's not just in Africa.
No solo es en África.
It's not just in the Middle East.
No es solo en el Medio Oriente.
Our cities.
Nuestras ciudades.
We're seeing brokenness.
Estamos viendo quebrantamiento.
We're seeing trafficking.
Hemos visto trata humana.
We're seeing the breakdown of the family.
Estamos viendo el quebrantamiento de la
children
familia.
Children being hurt.
Niños.
Spouses, women being hurt.
Mujeres y niños lastimados.
And so the churches in the U.S.
Así que las iglesias en Estados Unidos
are asking us to bring these materials from Africa.
Nos están pidiendo que traigamos estos materiales desde África.
And contextualize
y que
them
los contextualicemos
for the cities of the United
para
States.
Las ciudades de Estados Unidos.
And the movement is starting here.
Y el movimiento está tomando lugar acá.
I want you to look at this verse through new eyes.
Yo quiero que vean esta escritura a través de otros ojos.
In fact, I'd like you to read this with me. I'd like you to stand
de hecho,
with me to read this
yo
scripture.
Quiero que ustedes se pongan de pie y leamos esta escritura juntos.
This is the verse that Jesus read.
Esta fue la escritura, el versículo que Jesús leyó.
When he went back to his hometown.
Cuando estaba en su pueblo.
And he read this verse about himself.
Y él leyó este versículo acerca de sí mismo.
And then he gave this vision to us.
Y él dio esta visión a nosotros.
And so we read this verse of scripture.
Así que leemos este versículo de la escritura.
And we realize Jesus wants us to be him.
Y nos damos cuenta que Jesús quiere que nosotros seamos él.
To those that are hurting.
Para aquellos que están dolientes.
Would you read this with me?
¿Pueden leer esto conmigo?
The sovereign Lord has
el Espíritu del Señor
filled me with His Spirit.
Está sobre mí.
He has chosen me,
porque me ha ungido
and sent me
y enviado
to bring good news
a predicar
to the poor,
las nuevas buenas a los abatidos,
to heal the brokenhearted,
a vendar a los quebrantados,
to announce release
de corazón
to the captives,
y a publicar la libertad a los cautivos,
and freedom to those in prison.
Y aquellos que están presos en la cárcel.
Amen. I want you to look at that middle portion of that verse.
Yo quiero que ustedes vean la mitad de la porción de ese versículo.
We have always thought about bringing good news to the poor.
Siempre hemos pensado en traer las buenas nuevas a los pobres.
We are very faithful to bring the scriptures into the prisons.
Somos muy fieles en llevar las escrituras a las cárceles.
We see people get set free in our worship services.
Vemos a personas siendo liberadas en nuestros servicios de adoración.
But just think how challenged we are.
Pero piensa qué tan retados somos.
With the broken hearts of today.
Con los corazones quebrantados de hoy día,
from all over the world,
de todo el mundo,
all ethnicities,
de todas las etnias,
ages, genders,
edades, géneros,
the broken,
el quebrantado,
and the church is being called,
y la iglesia está siendo llamada,
to be Jesus to these people,
a ser Jesús a estas personas.
Transformation is happening.
La transformación está tomando lugar.
We cannot just hand them a Bible.
No solo le podemos dar una Biblia.
They're too wounded.
Están demasiado lastimados.
And so we've got to bring ministry to them in their heart language.
Así que tenemos que traer ministerio en su idioma natal.
Since we began doing this, we've trained 1.3 million people.
Desde que comenzamos esto, hemos trabajado con 1,300,000 personas.
We worked with 420 organizations.
Hemos trabajado con 420 organizaciones.
YWAM is one of those 420.
Es una de esas 420. Gloria a Dios.
There are some other ones that have begun training to heal in their ministries.
Hay otras que han comenzado entrenamiento para traer sanidad a través de sus ministerios.
International Justice Crew.
Cruzada estudiantil,
World Vision,
internacional de justicia, visión mundial,
compasión. It has now spread to 68 countries.
Ahora ha alcanzado a 68 países.
At the very heart of it,
y al corazón de esto,
what we call ground zero,
estamos llamado a lo que llamamos nivel cero,
where God birthed this into Bible society,
donde Dios hizo dar a luz esto en la sociedad bíblica.
Was in Goma.
Está en
Goma.
En Goma.
In the DRC.
En la República del Congo,
5 million people,
5 millones de personas,
killed in the civil war,
en la guerra civil,
around the Great Lake,
alrededor del Gran Lago.
And this place,
y en este lugar,
is where this healing methodology,
es donde esta metodología de sanidad,
was birthed,
nació,
and anybody
y cualquier
can be part of it.
Persona puede ser parte de esto.
Anybody can be a facilitator.
Cualquier persona puede ser un facilitador.
It doesn't take an MDiv.
No necesita
a master in divinity.
Una maestría en divinidad.
It doesn't. You don't need a PhD.
No necesitas un doctorado.
You don't need a college degree.
No necesitas un bachillerato.
But to have a heart for healing.
Para tener un corazón por
and
la
a heart
sanidad.
For the people.
Y un corazón por las
the
personas.
The ability to listen.
La habilidad de escuchar.
Serve the broken.
Servir al quebrantado.
And minister to them.
Y ministrarles.
I'm about to show you what's happened in the last 6 years.
Les voy a mostrar rápidamente lo que ha sucedido en los últimos 6 años.
This is what God has done.
Esto es lo que Dios ha hecho.
I have a dream.
Yo tengo un sueño.
What would happen to this map?
¿Qué sucedería a este mapa?
If YWAM embraced this methodology.
Si Hukum abrazase esta metodología, qué increíble sería.
I'd like to show you another video.
Me gustaría mostrarles otro video.
These are two of the leaders of this movement.
Estos son dos de los líderes de este movimiento.
These are the people who have helped design it.
Estas son las personas que han ayudado a diseñarlo.
So it can multiply and flow.
Para que se pueda multiplicar y fluir.
It can grow exponentially.
Pueda crecer exponencialmente.
Because of the leadership of these two people.
Y bajo el liderazgo de estas dos personas. Escuchen con cuidado.
Listen with your heart.
Escuchen con su corazón.
Traumatic events like war, natural disasters, and abuse often leave people with invisible wounds of the heart. Relational, emotional, psychological, and spiritual wounds. Without help, traumatized people can become trapped in cycles of poverty, violence, depression, and doubt. But through an unprecedented approach to deep and intentional scripture engagement, hurting people all around the world are finding new hope. In 2011, Reverend Dr. Bagudekia Alabeo helped American Bible Society launch its Bible-based trauma healing program in the Great Lakes region of Africa. The program combines the restoration narrative of scripture with mental health principles, equipping local churches to care for traumatized people. But for Dr. Alabeo, trauma isn't a distant phenomenon. He's seen the emotional and spiritual wounds of trauma in his home country, the Democratic Republic of the Congo. In 2009, his own family had to flee from the devastation caused by the Lord's Resistance Army there. With this experience and more than a decade of pastoral work under his belt, helping to plant churches both in the Congo and here in the United States, Dr. Alabeo is a passionate champion for American Bible Society's mission trauma healing projects across the globe. Dr. Diane Langberg is a practicing psychologist who has pioneered work with trauma survivors for more than 30 years. Dr. Langberg travels the world speaking about women, trauma, and Christian ministry. She is the director of Diane Langberg and Associates near Philadelphia, the chair of the American Association of Christian Counselors, and the author of numerous books, including her new release, Suffering and the Heart of God. Dr. Langberg teaches at Biblical Seminary's Global Trauma Recovery Institute and knows the power of scripture engagement to help heal the wounds of the heart. She's also a columnist for Christian Counseling Today and chairs American Bible Society's Global Alliance for Mission Trauma Healing.
Dr. Langberg and Dr. Alabaya, welcome. We're so grateful that you're here. And I wonder, Dr. Langberg, if you could begin by just helping frame for us what it looks like for the church to include trauma in what it sees and what it responds to in the world.
Well, of course, the body of Christ has done many things around the world, including bringing the scriptures and water and food and jobs and education. But I think we as the church have rarely seen trauma as a place of service. Trauma is an evil that destroys human beings created in the image of God. It does it through things like war or genocide, trafficking, child abuse, domestic violence, and of course, among the millions of refugees of today, we see many traumatized people as well. Trauma overwhelms normal human coping. It torments the mind, it wounds the heart, and it shatters faith and hope. A doctor dealing with rape in the Democratic Republic of Congo said this: the invisible wounds of trauma are far more devastating to repair and far harder to heal. So I think that if we would stand together and look out on the great sea of suffering humanity, that we might perhaps begin to see that trauma is the greatest mission field of the 21st century.
Dr. Alabe, this is both a professional concern to you, but it's also a personal experience, and maybe you're willing to share a little bit about that personal side as we talk here.
Thank you, Diane. Thank you, Andy. Yes, when it's about a trauma, my homeland, the Democratic Republic of Congo, has experienced a lot of hardship and violence more than anybody can imagine. When I was 8 years old, a civil war erupted in my country. There were mass killings of innocent people. Children were kidnapped and forced to kill people in brutal ways. The murder, the violence I witnessed traumatized me for a long time. My family and I escaped into jungle to avoid being kidnapped, to avoid being killed. And we had to hide out of there for about 2 years. We chose to face wilderness, starvation, and sickness. This was better than to put ourselves at the mercy of the rebels. In the midst of all of this, the source of my hope was just reading the Bible, singing hymns, and going to God in prayer. Since then, Diana, I have seen God at works through the power of his word. The word of God, it brings healing and hope to the wounded heart of our people around the world.
Wow. It strikes me, you said, Dr. Langberg, that trauma overwhelms normal or ordinary coping mechanisms. But what you're giving us, at least the beginning of a picture, is that there are these extraordinary resources available in the Word, in encounter with God in Scripture. Can you talk about what it looks like for the church to engage with this?
Well, as your story makes very clear, thinking of you as an 8-year-old boy, trauma makes human beings very vulnerable. And they are very hungry for safety and care, as you were in the jungle. Trauma is a global problem, and governments can't solve it. It is too massive and too complex, and besides, governments do not tend to heart wounds. And so I believe that the largest global group of people in the world, as much as trauma is a global problem, the church is a global presence. And that she is called by her Lord to enter into dark and difficult places, bringing his light and life into those places. The Bible Society's book, Healing the Wounds of Trauma, I think, offers a tool to God's people to train them to be both competent and scripture-based in responding to trauma and how it affects human beings. And many people, many organizations are partnering and catching the vision of working with trauma, learning to understand what it does to people so that they can respond effectively, not just in word, but also in deed, so that human hearts can be healed from the terrible wounds that they have suffered. Listen to some words from a genocide survivor in Rwanda who witnessed unspeakable atrocities and who also went through the trauma training that the Bible Society has. She said this to me a few years ago, "Diane, I only saw evil. I no longer believed that God was good. The church was not a sanctuary for my family. It was a cemetery. But then you came, and you listened to my pain, and you heard my broken heart, and now I think I can believe that God too is listening, and that he hears my pain, and can be my sanctuary because I have gotten a glimpse of him through you." The word was made flesh for you and for me, and I believe that we have been called to do the same for the world. And it is my prayer that we as his people will follow him into the dark places of this earth, throwing the shadow of his great glory over the suffering of people.
One of the things you heard,
una de las cosas que han escuchado,
Diane say,
que dijo Diane,
is that this trauma, this woundedness,
es que este trauma y estas heridas que han sido creadas,
is the greatest mission field of the 21st century.
Es el campo misionero más grande del siglo 21.
It's everywhere we serve.
Está en cualquier lugar en que estamos sirviendo.
And it's up to us to get trained.
Y depende de nosotros que nos entrenemos o capacitemos
to be ready to minister to the wounded.
Para estar listos para ministrar a aquellas personas quienes están heridas.
So I'm inviting you to that tonight.
Así que les estoy invitando ustedes en esta noche a esto.
abs.us/traumahealing.
Ahí está el portal de internet.
Has incredible resources.
Tiene recursos increíbles.
We are available to come and train.
Estamos disponibles para venir a entrenar.
We want to give ourselves away.
Queremos darnos de nosotros mismos.
We want to be your partner if you feel called into this ministry.
Queremos ser sus compañeros de trabajo. Ustedes sienten llamados a este ministerio.
Everything we have we share with YWAM.
Todo lo que nosotros tenemos para compartir con Hukum.
I'm a YWAMer.
Yo soy Hukumero.
It's yours.
Es de ustedes.
So let's dream about the future.
Así que soñemos acerca del futuro.
What would it look like if Bible-based trauma healing?
¿Cómo se vería ese concepto bíblico que rescata el trauma y la sanidad?
Became part of the University of the Nations.
Y este entrenamiento fuese parte de la Universidad de las Naciones.
It became a training track all over the world.
Y fuera un seminario que sucediera alrededor del mundo.
Combining this world-class curriculum with
combinando
your world-class training.
Este currículum de nivel mundial con su entrenamiento
imagine
nivel mundial.
How God would prosper that.
Y yo pido que Dios prospere esto.
And the map could be filled with places of healing.
Y que el mapa pueda ser lleno de lugares de sanidad.
Using the word of God in the heart language.
Utilizando la palabra de Dios en el idioma natal o materno.
You see, Bible poverty
ustedes ven que la pobreza bíblica
is not just American Bible Society problem.
No solo el problema de la sociedad bíblica norteamericana.
It's not just the YWAM problem.
Es un problema de Jukum.
It's not a problem of any one organization.
No es solo de una organización.
This is a problem for the church to grapple with.
Es un problema con el que toda la iglesia se tiene que debatir.
This is a God-sized challenge.
Este es un reto del tamaño de Dios.
And so we'll call upon him.
Así que vamos a clamar a él.
To give us the strength.
Para que nos dé la fortaleza.
To see every translation completed.
Para ver cada traducción completada.
To see the scriptures in the hands of every man, woman, child.
Para ver las escrituras en las manos de cada mujer, hombre, niño.
To see trauma healing available all over the world.
Para ver este entrenamiento de trauma y sanidad alrededor de todo el mundo.
That we might see with our own eyes.
Que podamos ver con nuestros propios ojos.
The end of Bible poverty.
Erradicar la pobreza bíblica.
Together.
Juntos.
God bless you.
Dios les bendiga.
Wow, what an incredible challenge.
Qué reto más increíble.
Do you feel challenged but also encouraged?
¿Se sienten retados, pero animados, juntos?
Come on.
Vamos.
Let me ask again. Do you
déjeme
feel
preguntarles otra vez más.
Encouraged but also
¿se
challenged tonight?
¿Animados y retados también esta noche?
Do you want to be part of seeing the end of Bible poverty?
¿Quieren ver y ser parte de erradicar la pobreza bíblica?
In our generation, give a big shout out to the Lord.
Generación, démosle un clamor al Señor.
Together we can do this.
Juntos lo podemos hacer.
It's unprecedented just to see the incredible unity around this whole area.
Sin precedente la unidad que estamos teniendo alrededor de esta área.
This area of the Word of God.
Esta área de la palabra de Dios.
And everybody must play a part.
Y cada persona debe tomar su papel o jugar su rol.
And I think this is the beautiful thing what I love about YWAM.
Y yo creo que esto es lo que yo amo acerca de Jukum.
That some of us we've come from what was considered to be previously mission fields.
Que algunos de nosotros hemos venido de lo que previamente se consideraba un campo de misiones.
But we're taking our place around the table.
Pero estamos tomando nuestro lugar alrededor de la mesa.
From Africa, Asia, Latin America.
De África, Asia, Latinoamérica.
And we want to say we want to be part of this.
Sí, queremos ser parte de eso.
And this is the amazing thing about.
Y esto es lo increíble.
How YWAM has welcomed us and embraced
de cómo Jukum nos ha dado la bienvenida y nos ha abrazado.
That from Africa we can go as missionaries.
Ir como misioneros.
West Africa, can I get an amen?
¿Puedo hacer un amén de África?
From Latin America we can be part of God's dream.
Ser parte del sueño de Dios.
From Asia.
De Asia.
But we still need Europe.
Pero todavía necesitamos Europa.
And what about America, North America?
Estados Unidos todavía.
Come on, guys.
Vamos.
We need you.
Lo necesitamos.
We need everybody.
Necesitamos a todos.
The scriptures in every language.
La escritura está en cada idioma.
Bible engagement.
Involucramiento bíblico.
Getting into the Word of God.
Ahondar en la palabra del Señor.
And seeing God using the Word.
Y ver a Dios utilizar la palabra.
By His Holy Spirit to bring.
A través de su Espíritu Santo.
A wave of healing to the most broken.
Una sanidad, una ola de sanidad al más quebrantado.
And the most vulnerable.
Y a los más vulnerables.
Just that piece of art from Christian.
Esa parte, ese increíble trabajo de arte de Christian.
That he painted during the worship time.
Que pintó durante el tiempo de adoración.
A wall, but with hands coming through the walls.
Una pared, pero manos abriendo la pared.
Something on the facade that looks so strong, so insular. What's that? Something that looks so strong
algo
on the facade.
Que tal vez se ve tan duro.
But we see the hands coming through it.
Pero tú ves las manos abriéndolo.
And maybe tonight you feel weak, you feel vulnerable.
En esta noche te sientes débil o vulnerable.
You've seen the faces in the videos.
Has visto los rostros en los videos.
You've heard the challenge.
Has escuchado el reto.
But you are asking yourself, what can I do?
Pero te preguntas a ti mismo y misma, ¿qué puedo hacer?
To be part of seeing the end of Bible poverty.
Para ser parte de erradicar la pobreza bíblica.
And in these three areas that we've heard from Dr. Roy Peterson tonight.
Tres áreas que escuchamos del Dr. Roy Peterson en esta noche.
If you want to be part of this challenge,
si quieres ser parte de este reto, quieres responder en tu corazón.
Why don't you just stand to your feet tonight?
¿Qué tal si te pones de pie en esta noche?
And say, Lord, you see how weak I feel.
Señor, tú ves que tan débil me siento.
How impossible the task may be.
Qué tan imposible puede que sea la tarea.
But I want to bring what I can.
Pero yo quiero traer a ti.
My few fish, my few loaves.
Mis panes, mis peces.
And together, as you multiply it, we can
juntos,
see a difference.
A medida que tú lo multiplicas, vamos a ver la diferencia.
Just wherever you're standing across the auditorium.
Ahí donde estás, alrededor del auditorio.
We pray tonight that God will just touch our hearts.
Oramos en esta noche que Dios toque nuestros corazones.
And all we have to do is just to say yes to Him.
Y todo lo que tenemos que decirle es sí, Señor.
That's all He's looking for.
Eso es lo que Él está buscando nada más.
Yes, we feel weak.
Sí, sentimos los débiles, nos sentimos débiles.
But God has seen our faithfulness.
Pero Dios ha visto nuestra fidelidad.
And like Revelation says, He has set before us.
Dice, ha puesto entre nosotros
an open door that no one can shut.
Una puerta abierta que nadie puede cerrar.
And Lord, we want to thank you tonight.
Y Señor, te agradecemos en esta noche.
As we've heard the challenge tonight.
Que a medida que hemos escuchado este reto en esta noche.
As we see the brokenness in our world today.
A medida que vemos el quebrantamiento en nuestro mundo de hoy día.
We thank you for the hope we have in your word.
Te agradecemos por la esperanza que tenemos en tu palabra.
That your word heals, your word
que tu palabra sana, tu palabra transforma.
And so as we respond to you tonight.
Y como en respuesta a ti en esta noche.
And we give you our gifts.
Te damos nuestros dones.
We give you our talents.
Nuestros talentos.
Lord, we even give you our fears.
Señor, aún te damos nuestros temores.
We pray that you will take it tonight.
Oramos que tú los tomes.
Take our hearts tonight.
Toma nuestros corazones en
take
esta noche.
Our weaknesses tonight.
Toma nuestras debilidades en
take
esta noche.
Take our vulnerabilities tonight.
Toma nuestras habilidades en esta noche.
We place it all into your hands.
Las ponemos en tus manos.
And we pray that you will use us, Lord.
Y pedimos que nos utilices, Señor.
As we say yes to you and with simple obedience.
Y a medida que te decimos sí, Señor, con una obediencia simple.
To do the next thing that you call us to do.
Para hacer la próxima cosa que nos llames de hacer.
We thank you for that.
Te agradecemos por eso.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
And all God's people say.
Y todo el pueblo de Dios dice.
Amen.
Amen.
Whoa.